Hello, welcome to Faith Encounter Devotionals today. My name is Ovie and I'm excited to be with you on this episode. Today, I want to be talking about something that I've tagged the mirror of the Word of God. You know, I believe as Christians, as believers, it's important for us to go through this and always look at the Word of God as the mirror for our life. You see, the Bible says in James chapter 1, it says, count it all joy when you fall into various and diverse trials, you know, because you need to have the right mentality, you know, whenever things face you or when you're faced with challenges. You know, don't always cry and say, why me? You know, but it says, count it all joy, because the Bible says all things work together for good. You know, God may not be the one bringing it your way, but it definitely will work for your good. It says, because we know this, that the testing of our faith produces patience. And that's what it says in verse 3. And then in verse 4, he says, let patience have its perfect work in you. And why does it say so? It says, because when patience has its perfect work in you, you will be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. Oh, isn't that a wonderful place to be? You know that whenever you go through things, you always look at it on the brighter side of things. You always see things from the brighter perspective. You know, the Bible says in the next verse that if you want wisdom, if you lack it, you know, you may not know how to go about situations. There are times that things will come and throw you off balance. You know, but the Bible is clear. It says, ask of God who gives wisdom. If you lack wisdom, you may need wisdom in a specific area. You know, God gives it to you freely. Go to His Word and seek out His wisdom and ask Him faith. You know, ask God in faith. Read His Word in faith, not doubting. Because the man who doubts is like a wave, tossed to and fro. You know, you're unstable in all your ways. And you know what happens about a man who's unstable, about an individual who's unstable? The Bible says, let him not suppose, let him not think that he will receive anything from the Lord. Wow, this is a place that you do not want to be, you know, where you're not even on the good side of God. You know, he says, let that man not think that he will receive anything because he's double-minded, unstable. Some of you may be experiencing instability in your marriage, at work, in your relationships, at different in your spiritual walk with God. You know, it's just because today you're here, tomorrow you're there. It says you need to ask in faith. You need to come to the Lord in faith. The Bible says we should come boldly before the throne of grace. You know, and it encourages us that when we study His Word, whatsoever things are lawful, whatsoever things are, you know, honest, whatsoever things are of good report, it says, meditate on these things, think on these things, and once you grasp a hold of His Word, you know, don't just stop there. Be a doer. You know, the Bible says in James chapter 1 verse 22, he says, be doers of the Word and not hearers only. You know, we come to church, we hear sermons online, we hear messages, we read the Word, but you have to do this with faith and be committed to doing His Word. Because if you're not a doer of the Word, he says you are like the man who looks at his natural face in a mirror. You look at a mirror and you go away and forget what you were, you know. And the Bible says that he observes himself. He goes away and he forgets what he looks at. And in verse 25, he says, but he who looks into the perfect law of liberty, hallelujah, and continues in it. You know, the God's Word is the perfect law of liberty. I like the way one translation put it. It says, God's Word for free men. Oh, it's a wonderful thing. The Word of God, we get strength. We draw ability. We draw direction from His Word. Do not forget. It's like a lady who's doing makeup. Sometimes she may dab here and dab there and she walks away and someone tells her, oh, you have a speck on your face. And then what does she do? She goes back to the mirror. Number one, she checks, is there really a speck or is this a prank? Number two, she looks at the mirror and uses it to correct it and say, oh, I add a little powder here, I add a little makeup here and touch it up. That's what we do with the Word of God. When things come at you, the devil tells you you're a failure, you go back to the Word. What does the Word say? You pick alignment, you take your cue from the Word of God. The Bible says that you are the head and not the tail. He has given unto you all things that pertain to life and godliness. You're a spiritual being. The Bible says that you are head and not the tail. You shall, you know, there are so many things. You are the healed of the Lord. The doctor tells you something else. You know, you go back to the Word. You do not be a forgetful hearer. Your immediate situation may not be pointing to that, but you go back to the Word, the mirror of life, the mirror of the word, and you say, oh, this is what it does, this is what it says, and you go back in life. And then when something else comes and tells you something, you go back, you say, no, that's not who I am. I just looked at the mirror. It was all clear. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Remember, it says, it is that one who is blessed in his deed. You are blessed when you do it. You are not only blessed because you heard it or you read it, but you're blessed as you do it. You know, the Bible says in Hebrews that, you know, that we grow, that we become perfect, we become better at discerning between good and evil as we do, as we practice. You know, so this is a time for us to take cue. A lot of things are going on in the world around us, but this is a time where we always have to go back to the word and take cue, take direction, take correction from his word, and let his word be, it's like driving. You look at your side mirror, you look at your rear mirror, you look at things that are coming on behind, you look at things that are coming on the side. Let the word of God be that instrument, be that mirror that helps you check if you're on track, that helps you check if there's an oncoming vehicle, that helps you check for danger. His word is a mirror to our lives. I hope you've been blessed by this word today. As you go on with your day, have a blessed day and see you next time.